everybody. My name is Lisa Kessler, and I am here today again on behalf of Cheers for Charity. And I am so thrilled to be here with my friend Joanne. Hey, Joanne.
Hi, Lisa. Hi, yes, I'm Joanne Verchak with Lighthouse Physical Therapy, and ready for another great session for Cheers for Charity. And today we have Jonathan from the Woodman Museum out of Dover, New Hampshire. If anyone has not heard of it, we have a busy phone there today too.
Apparently, sorry about that.
That's okay. Well, Jonathan, welcome. Please introduce yourself. And then for anybody that does not know about the Woodman Museum, just, you know, give them the highlights. What's it all about?
Yeah. So hello, my name is Jonathan Nichols. I'm the executive director here at the Woodman Museum in Dover, New Hampshire. We are a historic museum. We've been open for about 106 years now. So we're going into our 106th season here. I am so sorry. Put that in the cabinet. Okay.
There we go.
So yes, we've been open for about 106 years now. We specialize in art, history, and science with a specific focus on American history. So we have four houses on our campus. The Woodman House, which is the namesake of the museum, was owned by Annie Woodman. She is the primary benefactor of the museum in 1916. She left $100,000 to the trustees of the museum to set up this place, which equates to about $2 million of today's money. And so with the idea of art, history, and science. So her house was purchased with that money, as well as the Hale House next door. And then we acquired the Dam Garrison from its final owner, Ellen P. Rounds, around the same time for the opening of the museum. And then in 2004, we acquired the Keefe House, which is our art space and our office space. So the Woodman House has natural history for the most part in the form of taxidermy. So lots of old animals. Our big draw is our 10-foot tall polar bear that is on display, as well as a mineral room. And then on the third floor, we have military history. The Dam Garrison was built in 1675 and is one of its only remaining examples of a colonial garrison that we're lucky enough to have. It was donated by its final owner, as I was saying, L.M.P. Rounds. And it is tourable. So it has a lot of artifacts that she personally collected, ranging from the 1600s all the way up until the early 1900s. And then we have the Hale House, which is the former residence of Senator John P. Hale from Dover, New Hampshire. And that houses Dover and New Hampshire specific artifacts, as well as an antique and colonial furniture exhibit on the second floor. Other than that, we have two sheds outside on our grounds that we have a cannon display in. It's a Civil War cannon, a 12-pound Napoleon, and a hearse shed that was donated by Tasker's Funeral Home. So we have a Victorian horse-drawn hearse and some of their equipment from their facility. The last tourable area is our carriage barn, which is currently being worked on. The first floor has some antique carriages, a general store setup, and a blacksmithing area. And then the second floor is woodworking, tools, farm equipment, a shipping area, and then an ice harvesting and winter exhibit. So we've been called a very eclectic museum, which I think fits the bill on that. So you name it, we probably have something about that. Apart from our museum space, we also hold art shows in our Keefe House, concert series on our grounds, and then various events. Our most, the one coming up recently is Memorial Day. So we go to a cemetery down the road and have a memorial service there. So yeah, I think that's, we do a lot.
Yes, you do.
Yes.
What a great place. So just out of curiosity, do you have a favorite exhibit there?
So let's see. I have a couple, I would say. The one that comes to mind is the cannon shed. My primary focus when I was in college was on the Civil War. I also do Civil War reenacting as a hobby. So my Civil War unit that I'm a part of is the ones that actually went and restored that cannon. So my picture is actually up in the shed as in my Civil War like gear. So it's pretty cool. As well as we have a music box that was built in Geneva, Switzerland in the 1860s that is still playable. So that's one of my favorite ones to bring people to because you can still hear what people were listening to in the 1860s. So I would say those are my two absolute favorites.
That's great. And I assume you're still curating more items for the museum. People are still... Where do you get your stuff from now on? You know, I mean, I know it's probably chock full already. Do you still get donations from people or how does that work?
Every day. So we get donations from all over. A lot of descendants of prominent people from Dover's history, the museum itself, and then just local residents who have some connection with an artifact from their family that we put on display. So we have a myriad of donations every day, I would say, ranging from, we just had someone give us some artwork. He's a direct descendant of one of our first curators. So we have that. We've had also Abraham Lincoln's, one of his last saddles that he ever rode before he was assassinated on display. And that was a donation from our first head trustee of the museum who happened to be his aide-de-camp at the time. So Colonel Daniel Hall was his aide-de-camp and the first head trustee in the 1900s. So we are lucky to have that. So it's a... It's
very fascinating.
It's always an interesting day. It's like a little mini Christmas. Anytime yeah. someone comes in, see what we got. Yeah.
Now, do you tend to like restore some things for a while, or you know, is pretty much everything you have out?
So, it depends on what we receive and the condition it's in. I mean, we receive a ton of stuff all the time, as I was saying. So, some don't immediately go out on display. We have a handful of storerooms throughout the buildings here that we keep things. And we just try to find where they fit. So we have one gallery that specifically rotates every year, our Foster Gallery, that changes with every season. So this season we're focusing on Dover's past celebrations, anniversaries, because next year, 2023, is the 400th anniversary of the founding of Dover, which was settled in 1623 and is the seventh oldest settlement, or European settlement in the nation. So that's what we themed it. This year, we've done other things from a peek at the past is what we called it. So that was to show younger generations just what is on their cell phone. So we had, some old calculators, some typewriters, calendars, anything that you can find as an app now on your phone, we had an artifact about it. So that one was an interesting.
So what things do you have coming up that people could look forward to participating in?
Yeah, so we have a whole bunch of events going on throughout the year. Like I was saying, our closest one is Memorial Day. That's going to be on Memorial Day itself, Monday, May 30th, at Pine Hill Cemetery in Dover. That's the large cemetery in the south end of town. We'll be doing we'll have the mayor here to speak at that. We have a retired Navy veteran who's going to come speak. We'll do a wreath laying, a playing of taps, and then the 1st New Hampshire Light Artillery, that Civil War reenact group that I was talking about. We'll actually be there with their cannon as to perform a cannon salute and then do some demonstrations down at lower fields. So that's the closest one we have. Other than that, we have a summer concert series four coming up from June through July. We also do guest lecture series in the fall So we have four of those as well, with a whole range of topics, some art related, some history specific. And then what else do we have? We also do Veterans Day here as well. So that one is like our Memorial Day kind of on steroids. So we don't just have a Civil War reenactment group. We also have reenactment groups from every major war that America has been a part of. So ranging from the Revolution all the way up, I think to Vietnam was the last that we had. So the whole grounds will be covered in different reenactment groups, and you can come see different style uniforms and armaments, vehicles. We've also had a whole bunch of like Jeeps and stuff from Vietnam on display as well. And then the big one for Halloween, or at least the October season, we do an event called Voices from the Cemetery, which is also held at Pine Hill and is a walking tour during the day, where we'll have costumed interpreters portraying different individuals from Dover's history. So you can learn about them.
But only during the day, huh?
Only during the day. It's a family-friendly event. Yes. Educational, meant for the whole family to enjoy.
I've been hogging all the time.
There's so much that you do and so much going on. And I've taken a ton of notes. I can't wait to go check it all out. I knew it was cool, but it's way cooler than I even expected. So what's the best way that people can find out when they can go visit, get the list of all the events? How can they follow you? What if they want to donate? What if they want to volunteer? How do they connect with you?
Absolutely. So we have a website that is woodmanmuseum.org. I'll admit that is not the best website in the world at the moment. We are currently working on a brand new website that will have the same domain name and should be active within the next month or so. But that's where you can find everything about the history of the houses, some upcoming events, my contact info, as well as our director of operations, Mike Day. If you want to get involved, we are always on the lookout for volunteers here for tours and events and sponsorships as well. You can make all those donations right there on our webpage. We also have a Facebook and Instagram, and brand new as of like last week, we have a TikTok page. So I won't be doing any dances or anything like that, but we'll have some fun educational videos on there as well.
That's fantastic. Awesome. Well, can't wait to come check it out and see it all in person. And I so appreciate you being here with us today. This is fascinating. I want to see the polar bear. And I want to see the music box. So,
yeah, well, we'd love to have you.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, thanks so much for being with us today, Jonathan. What you do is so important in preserving our history and educating our communities about, you know, all those important things that the art, the history, the science that all goes with that. So, so we thank you for your efforts and your organization's efforts.
Awesome. Thank you very much for having me.
Our pleasure.